You need to break conventional thought. In what sense I say conventional thought is because a lot of people, they invest in probably ILPs or unit trusts, okay? And very seldom people know about this thing called ETF. And I just want to let people know that it is a very viable investment option. Even for the layman, you don't need to have very in-depth financial knowledge in order to use them properly, okay? So what is an exchange-traded fund? In short, that was what ETF meant for, exchange-traded fund, okay? So let's break down the term. Exchange-traded, it actually means that listed on the stock exchange. And so you can buy this instrument like you buy and sell normal stocks, okay? So it's very simple. That's why it's called exchange-traded. And what is a fund? A fund is basically a basket of securities that is managed by a fund manager. Okay, so when you buy a unit trust, it's also a fund, and there's a fund manager who decides what are the stocks and what are the bonds to be inside this this fund. Okay, so there is a decision maker in a sense. So ETF, in short, is a fund that is traded on the exchange, and it buy and sell like normal stocks. All right, and there are three important terms that I need to explain to you. Things like index. Okay, so what is an index? You often hear that. During the news, right, every day they will say, during the business segment of the news, they will say something like this, oh, the Singapore stock market went up today by 1%, etc. Alright, what does that even mean? So, they actually base off something called an index. So, for example, let's explain first, right, a stock index is a theoretical value of a basket of stocks to represent a particular segment in the stock market. So, for example, the Straits Times Index is what the broadcasters locally use to describe whether the Singapore stock market goes up or down. All right, so it's STI in short, Straits Times Index. And almost every country have this their own country index, and there are a lot of indices in the world that more than you know and I know, okay? It's almost impossible to track. I think there are thousands and thousands of indices around the world, not just in stocks, it can be bonds, it can be in commodities, etc., etc. So a Straits Times Index is nothing complicated. So it's made up of 30 stocks, and all these stocks are probably very well known, right? They are your blue chip companies, a lot of them are Temasek linked companies, and these are the bluest of the bluest. Okay, so these 30 stocks make up the STI index, and because they represent almost 70% of the total Singapore stock market, right? That's why the movement of these 30 stocks is good enough to represent the entire stock market of Singapore. The question is, how is the STI constructed? Who determine whether these 30 stocks are there, right? So it's determined by these three companies jointly, SPH, Singapore Press Holdings, SGX Singapore Stock Exchange, and FTSE Russell, which is a UK indexing company, which is internationally known. And actually, why is it called Straits Times Index, right? A little bit history, right? So it started in, if I'm not wrong, 1966, and it was Straits Times that publishes this index in those days. That's why it was called Straits Times Index, like it's our national paper, right? The Straits Times. So that's how it got its name. So over the years, that's where they got more professional indexing company like FTSE to take part in the methodology in calculating these indices. So these three companies, do they just look at the 700 to 800 stocks in Singapore and say, oh, I like this stock, I put inside, I like this stock, let's vote. Alright, it is not that case. How they do it is actually by pure mathematics. Alright, and let me show you the formula. Ta-da! This is the formula, okay? So you don't need to care about how this is derived, okay? The exact formula. I just want to show you that there is a formula. And most importantly, you just need to know the index was constructed based on pure mathematics, all right? Pure mathematics. There wasn't any qualitative assessment or anything. It is just pure math. And the concept is that it is market-weighted. That means the bigger the stock, the more float that it has in the stock market, right? That means more shares traded in the stock market, right? Value, okay, in terms of value, they get a bigger weightage in the index, okay? And you can see most of the bigger companies that's in the index are your telcos and your banks, okay? Because they are the more influential, more heavier stocks that is representing the index. So it's pure math. Every day they will calculate this value and it determines the STI value for the day. Okay. And the latest change, so it is not always the same, 30 stocks, it will change. And the latest change was done last quarter in March. So Noble, because of all the alleged fraud, right, about their investments in Australia, etc., and their accounting practices, so their share price have dropped a lot, and which means their market weight has also dropped, because market weight is dependent on the share price as well. So Noble Group has fell out of the index, and CapitaLand Commercial Trust has been added in. So there is a reserve list that the three companies, SPH, SGX and FTSE, curate, and they will tap on this reserve list whenever required. So they meet every 3 months to reconstruct the STI again. So there may be changes. So far, actually, for the past few years, there have been changes every year. Okay, so the latest one was Noble Group, was replaced by CapitaLand Commercial Trust.